Libertad have become a team to watch in this year's Copa Libertadores, another Copa Libertadores week is in the books. South America's biggest club competition continues in its group stage. As the midway point approaches, the teams capable of progressing are revealed, while other sides struggle to keep pace. Here's what happened on match day 4. Tuesday, Defensor Sporting, Uru, 3-1 Monagas, Vent, Cerro Porteño, Park 0-0 Gremio, Bra, Millonarios, Call, 4-0 Deportivo Lara, Vent, Wednesday, The Strongest, Bowl, 1-2 Atletico Tucumán, Arg, Independiente, Arg 0-1 Corinthians, Bra, Flamengo, Bra, 1-1 Indup. Santa Fe, Call, Libertad, Par, 2-1 Peñarol, Uru, Thursday Racing, Arg, 4-0 Vasco da Gama, Bra, Universidad de Chile, Chi, 0-0 Cruzeiro, Bra, Emelec, AQ, 0-1. River Plate, Arg, Alianza Lima, Per, 0-2 Junior, Call. Here are the four biggest takeaways from the Copa Libertadores this past week. Argentinian success. Four Argentinian teams were in action. Three came away with victories. The lone disappointment was Independiente, losing to Corinthians. The reigning Brasileirão champions are contenders for this campaign's Copa Libertadores. Argentina's three winners all produced solid displays in tough environments. First, Atletico Tucumán. Not much was expected traveling to La Paz to face the strongest, but the Argentines came away with a crucial 2-1 victory. Nicolas Romat's goal of the tournament contender broke the deadlock for El Decano. Your browser doesn't support HTML5 video. Tremendo golazo de Nicolas Romat para poner el 1-0 parcial del Decano ante the strongest. https://t.co/sbr24chxjv340am the 19th of April 18 River Plate and Racing both conquered, 2. In Ecuador, Los Millonarios secured a vital 1-0 win against Emelec. Racing's emphatic 4-0 victory over a Brazilian side Vasco da Gama placed them atop Group E. The competition is strong with Cruzeiro and Universidad de Chile also involved, but Eduardo Couto's men are thriving under pressure to perform at the highest level. Brazilian struggles. Teams from Brazil are always candidates to lift the Copa Libertadores trophy. Although this year is no different, the past week's results were hugely disappointing. Five Brasileirão sides took to the pitch, yet only Corinthians escaped with 3 points. After drawing in Chile, Cruzeiro's situation reaches a pivotal stage next week in Belo Horizonte. Raposa must win against Universidad de Chile to retain realistic hopes of progressing. Picking up only a point against Paraguayan side Cerro Porteño means Gremio also still have work to do. Brazilian sides must improve performances in the Copa Libertadores before it's too late. Another beautiful goal. Romat was not the only player to score a stunner this past week. Oscar Taquara Cardozo is well known throughout the footballing universe. As well as representing Paraguay 51 times, the striker tore up Portugal's Primeira Liga while at Benfica. Cardozo now plays for Libertad Asunción in his native country. During the 2-1 comeback win over Peñarol, the 34-year-old struck in the last minute. Your browser doesn't support HTML5 video. Taquara Cardozo, el de los golazos. Gran remate de tiro libre para darle el triunfo Libertad sobre Peñarol por 2-1. It definitely has potential as the 2018 Copa Libertadores goal of the season, unless the select committee drops a clanger, Libertad rising as contenders. The Asunción-based team deserve attention. Libertad have an experienced squad loaded with quality. They top Group C, over Peñarol, Atletico Tucumán and the strongest, after taking a maximum 9 points. A spot in the next stage is all but confirmed. Perhaps, it is too early to tag Libertad title contenders. They are surpassing expectations, though. The Paraguayan side are certainly one to watch go